What's up, y'all? It's your boy J Mitch coming back to you with another review. This one is going to be as, you know, quick and, you know, thorough as possible, because there is a lot to comprehend in this video, or I should say song. There is a video version of it. It's just not the whole thing, and I want to review the whole song. So I'm going to be looking at the song today. I'll leave a link to the, you know, portion that is video in the description, but for right now I'm gonna be looking at the whole song and going over the lyrics. So this is JAG, Kapernick Effect. This was around the time that Colin Kaepernick was going around, you know, trying to spread awareness to the black violence, the violence that was happening to the black community by the police brutality murders. So once again, to just bring awareness and to make sure that everybody's on the same page, I decided to do another video of JAG voicing his opinion through his music. And I, you know, I believe that JAG does this in a very, you know, pinpoint way. But let's review some of the things that he says and break it down. Kaepernick Effect.
Officer, I just got off of work, officer. Grew up in church, officer. Loosen the cuffs for me, that shit kind of hurt, officer. No questioning, all you put my face in the dirt, officer.
Mean that a lot of black men in you know, these communities are facing and have faced. A lot of the times, black men will get racially profiled. They may be looking for somebody that looks like you, or they may just be messing with you and, you know, getting, doing something for their pleasure. Obviously voicing his opinion saying, I just got off of work, officer. I just got off of work, officer. And, you know, obviously just telling the officer, like, I don't want any problems. I just want to go home. I just, you know, just got off of work. And you'll hear him say, I grew up in church, you know, to say that, you know, he is not a violent person. He doesn't want to cause him harm. He's, you know, a good spirit. You know, he's not here to, you know, be a threat to this officer.
Why I feel like death, I'm like I'm about to get murked, officer. I ain't packing nothing, told that shit to the first officer. You stopping me because you enjoying the perks, officer. Please let me go, my baby about to get birth, officer.
So here it unfolds right here. I remember hearing this part for the first time, and I wasn't crying yet. You know, after I seen the visual, you know, it made me feel a little ways, but you know, it's real. A lot of people are not understanding the severity of the situation. This has been going on for decades and hundreds, you know, of years, if you want to be really technical. And, you know, he is just trying to voice his opinion and make sure that, you know, the cop is not, you know, there to hurt him. You know what I'm saying? He's trying to tell the cop, like, I got a baby to go home to. You know, I got a family at home. I just got off of work. Like, I'm not packing a gun. Like, I don't have a gun on me. I told that to the first officer when they came. A lot of the times you'll see these cops, like almost every situation that you're in, you'll see it today on the news, they'll call for backup. They'll dispatch their backup, and you know, the whole, you know, most of the time when there's not riots going on and not every cop is on duty right then, you know, every cop that's in the town that's on duty at the moment will come to, you know, where you're at. And, you know, a lot of the times it's for no reason, because the black man is just trying to live his life and go home. That brings some emotion out right there.
You got your foot on my back and your heat on my head, spit in my face. That's worse than putting feet on my bed. All for a quarter. Look how your people treat me for bread. Innocent.
The cops and the black people of any and every community, they have, you know, they've had a disagreement. They've had beef. They've had, you know, whatever the case may be. It's not been a friendly relationship. Rarely ever is it a friendly relationship. A majority of black people can tell you that they've been through something similar, or they've dealt with with a group of police officers that were not treating them correctly. Let's keep going.
And so you shoot me and leave me for dead. Damn, mama watching the news, he got a dumb crying. Nigga bleeding out on the ground, she see her son dying. It's only one Ryan, she know that and she need me here. So be a soldier for real and just don't leave me here.
So I felt like there was a like weight on my chest. And I know some other people out there may feel like the, you know, the same way when those words hit, because it's like, wow, like I'm a human being. How you just gonna do me like this? Shoot me and leave me here. Like I'm, my mom got to see me, you know, she needs me is what he's saying. Like she needs me. I have a family too. And a lot of these times the situation and the, you know, whatever the case may be, the prejudice, the racism, whatever the reason is for the murder or for the injury that is inflicted on the black person in this particular situation. A lot of the times it's not worth it. It's not even, what are you doing it for? Is basically, you know, what I got from that line. If you don't get choked up or, you know, have a, you know, you're feeling in your stomach tingle when you hear that, like, don't leave me here. Like, wow, that just shows you, you know, it's actually a war out here, like, and devastating murders on national television. So, and they left the bodies just laying there for hours.
That's how you gon' act, boy. Wish I had my strap, boy. Wish I knew that y'all be blacking out, cause I'm a black boy. Black skin rapping for the blacks, you calling that noise. Point the gun at my head, me and tell me act, boys.
So I wanna be careful on how I voice my opinion, because I know that, you know, words can get misconstrued. But I'm just going to say that I definitely feel the pain and the anger and, you know, just the vibrations and the emotion in his words when he was, you know, putting this in the mic. When he was actually saying this, he can deliver that in a real way because it's real. It's an authentic feeling. That is not, it cannot be, you know, faked by a black man. It cannot be faked by a black man if you've been through it or if you've seen it unfold. And that's what I love about the authenticity of, you know, of JAG as an artist. You know, wish I had my strap, boy. Wish I know that y'all be blacking out because I'm a black boy. Like, that right there, that is different because you, all your life as a black person, you go through pain and turmoil and being turned down and so many other things. I mean, I'm not going to sit here and list them all, but, you know, basically being hated on for your skin tone, for whatever the case may be, for hundreds of years, it does something. Not only to one person or to one black man or, you know, just black men in general, it does something to our women, children. And, you know, obviously where we're at today in 2020 with the riots and everything, it's doing something for other people too.
Come to my hood and watch you niggas get drowned. This how I feel when white cops go tell a nigga get down. So get down, nigga. Lay down and stay down, nigga. And keep your hands behind your back or I'ma spray round, nigga. Pour it over so much, you gotta catch the greyhound, nigga. Your hands up, you bleed wrong, it's gonna be mayhem, nigga. Facts, your gun out, and you shooting cause I scared you. Well, if you get to shoot cause you scared, nigga, I'm scared too. Why we can't be equal, homie? Why my movie can't be long enough to see the sequel, homie? You ain't like the Reaper, homie. Why I can't stand in the street just for my people, homie? Y'all injecting us with poison and that shit is lethal, homie. Damn, it's like how I'm supposed to love y'all when all you do is act like no one is above y'all. And now I'm feeling like, how much do that love cost? Instead of real love, it really feel like love lost. I'll die for my freedom, let's get real for it. It's what it's like when you black and you get killed for it.
When I first saw this music video a couple years ago, or I'm sorry, I keep saying music video, the song, when I first heard the song 2 years ago, I was in a different mindset along with everybody else and was trying to go with the peaceful route. And, you know, just like JAG was feeling at this moment, we were in a position that made us feel like victims more than anything. Who knows what's going to happen in the future, but I know from this moment on, you know, cops are going to have, they're going to have to be held accountable. I know for this case specifically that JAG is talking about, the cop was not indicted. The cop was not, you know, charged immediately. He was treated as if he was protected. And that's one thing that I want to get across to everyone that's watching this video. Being protected by corruption and evil, it's only going to go so far. Because when there's so many black people that are upset, tired, eventually something's going to happen. And that's exactly what's going to, you know, that's exactly what's unfolding with the riots and everything. Some people are obviously taking advantage of it, but it started out as something, you know, as a message. We're not going to have this anymore. If this does not stop, X, Y, and Z is going to happen. Voice your opinion. You know, tell your black friends or your white friends what you're going through, what you feel, how it's changing you. What do you